A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 11th August, Sunday, on the front page you have certification of seeds to be made mandatory to step up agri output. So barcoding and tracking, it is said, could hike productivity by 25%. So Centre now hopes to mandate uniform certification by pushing through a replacement to Seeds Act 1966. So that would be pushed in winter session of the parliament. So all barcoding of all seeds will ensure their traceability. It is said this would increase agricultural productivity by up to 25%. Below you have curbs eased in Srinagar. People throng streets to buy essentials. Banks and ATMs are open now. Government employees get advanced salary ahead of Eid. And this is Congress names Sonia Gandhi as its interim president. Party says she will hold the post until fresh elections. Then below you have state oil marketing companies to buy biodiesel from used cook oil. So this is a bid to encourage biofuel sector. So Petroleum and Natural Gas Ministry has announced that state-run oil marketing companies would procure the entire supply of biodiesel produced from used cooking oil for a three-year period. So this is a move announced on the World Biofuel Day. That means biofuel plants using cooking oil as their raw material will be assured that their entire production will be procured by oil marketing companies. The scheme has been launched in 100 cities across the country. So here you can see even Food Safety and Security Standards, Food Safety and Standards Authority of India, it had directed Food Safety Commission to ensure that food business operators whose consumption of edible oils for frying is more than 50 liters per day stop reusing the oil more than 3 times. So that oil, you can see it is called repurposed used cooking oil. So this such a sticker has also been launched by the Petroleum Ministry. So procurement of such oil will be encouraged. On page 9 you have UP, Delhi, Rajasthan among worst performers in breastfeeding. So it is said mother's milk is one of the most cost-effective interventions to save children. So breastfeeding within 1 hour of birth, exclusive breastfeeding for 6 months and compulsory breastfeeding from 6 to 9 months is what the Ministry of Health recommends. But here you can see UP, Delhi, Rajasthan, Uttarakhand and Punjab fare the worst when it comes to the practice of breastfeeding. Even World Health Organization says that if breastfeeding was scaled up to near universal levels, lives of about 8,20,000 children could be saved every year. Then this is low-cost handheld device to help detect bacteria develop. So researchers from IIT Guwahati have developed a low-cost handheld biocompatible sensor that can detect bacteria almost instantaneously without cell culture and microbiological assays. On page 10, you have coastal security set up on high alert, says Navy. So Samudri Jihad, the Pakistan-based terror groups, is a known fact, is what the Navy Vice Admiral says. And this is Pakistan formally suspends trade ties. So the Pakistan has formally suspended trade relations with India after India revoked the special status for Jammu and Kashmir. Then this is peace deal inked with last NLFT faction. So central government has signed a memorandum of settlement with the last remaining faction of National Liberation Front of Tripura. So this is regarding that. So then on international page you have China continues to build Xinjiang camps. So despite government claim that most detainees were released, more re-education camps for Muslims have cropped up. On business page, you have draft policy on logistics ignores express industry. So draft national logistics policy has been released by the government and it is said it overlooks the role of the express industry, that is courier and parcel industry and air cargo sector in the multimodal transport mix for faster and cost effective movement of cargo. So this is a critique on it. Then on Sundays, you have FAQ coverage, frequently asked questions. So these are on issues which are in news over the week. So the first one is the forms of federalism in India. So this question is how has Jammu and Kashmir been altered And are there other states with special status? So yes, there are other states. Under Article 370, Jammu and Kashmir had special status. And under Article 371, many other states have. So this is a complete coverage on it. So it's very important. You can see this is 371A, 371B. 371A is for Nagaland. 371B, under which Meghalaya became a state later. Earlier, it had special provisions for Assam, under which Meghalaya lied. Then Article 371C for hill areas of Manipur. 371D is special status for Andhra Pradesh. You can see. So you can see. Then there is even 371F for people of Sikkim. 371G for Mizoram. 371H for Arunachal Pradesh. So there are other states also which have special status. Then this is now a currency war. So this question raises questions that why has US accused China of deliberately weakening the yuan, and what does it mean for the global economy? So this is a currency war because US currency is market determined, but China can tweak its currency. So this is an important issue. And this is, what is the fight between ISL and I League about? So this is regarding Indian Super League, set up to be named India's top football competition. Why is it so? And what happened to the earlier league? So this is little sports related. Then on Sundays, you have science and technology coverage. So here on this page, you have IIT Madras registers initial success with iron-ion battery. So this is a cost-effective battery which can store high amount of energy. And this is cancer stem cells can form blood lymphocytes within tumors. So this is a study which says that management of cancer cell is important because tumor needs both blood and lymph to grow and spread. Then here you have irrigation agriculture shift rainfall to northwestern India. So this is IIT Bombay study which says that any change in irrigation policy has the potential to shift monsoon rainfall as well. On the last page you have cost is key. Chinese space firm revs up for reusable rocket race. So the global boom in satellite deployment calls for frequent launches. So reusable rockets is the key in that, and on which China is working as well. And this is newly discovered lake in Nepal, maybe the world's highest. So this is called Kajin Sara, a lake which has been formed from Himalayan meltwater, and it has been recently discovered in Nepal, and it has, is likely to earn the distinction of the world's highest lake. The presently the title is for Tilcho Lake, also in the same region in Nepal. Then you have tackling poachers across borders. So DNA forensics has been used by India and Nepal to analyze wildlife crimes as such. This is there. You can see ivory being smuggled. So these are elephant tusks, ivory. Then below you have spacecraft in orbit operates on steam. So in a first, NASA has demonstrated the first coordinated maneuver between two water-powered spacecrafts in low Earth orbit. So the twin spacecrafts are orbiting Earth around about 9 kilometers from one another, and these two spacecrafts established a radio frequency communication cross-link to talk with each other. So these are steam-powered spacecrafts which were launched by NASA. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com. Thank you.